ample provision is made by the death of Christ for every soul. Jesus is our ever-present help in time of need. Only call upon him in faith, and he has promised to hear and answer your petitions. Oh, for living active faith. We need it. We must have it, or we shall fade and fail in the day of trial. The darkness that will then rest upon our path must not discourage us or drive us to despair. It is now that we must keep ourselves and our children unspotted from the world. It is now that we must wash our robes of character and make them white in the blood of the Lamb. It is now that we must overcome pride, passion, and spiritual slothfulness. It is now that we must awake and make determined effort for symmetry of character. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts. We are in a most trying position, waiting, watching for our Lord's appearing. The world is in darkness. But ye brethren, says Paul, are not in darkness that that day should overtake you. What are you doing, brethren, in the great work of preparation? Those who are uniting with the world are receiving the worldly mold and preparing for the mark of the beast. Those who are distrustful of self, who are humbling themselves before God and purifying their souls by obeying the truth, these are receiving the heavenly mold and preparing for the seal of God in their foreheads. Now is the time to prepare. The seal of God will never be placed upon the forehead of an impure man or woman. It will never be placed upon the forehead of the ambitious, world-loving man or woman. It will never be placed upon the forehead of men or women of false tongues or deceitful hearts. All who receive the seal must be without spot before God, candidates for heaven. Search the scriptures for yourselves, that you may understand the fearful solemnity of the present hour.
Friends, don't let the devil use hypnosis preachers, whether it's the pastor or whoever they are, to tell you that you're not going to be holy. You're going to sin until Jesus Christ comes. That's doctrines of the devils. When God says, be you holy because I'm holy. When Jesus Christ sets you free, Bible says, ye shall be free indeed. If you think that God is bigger than the devil, then you're going to be holy by the grace of God. But if you think that you're the devil, notice your devil is bigger than God, then the devil's going to make sure that he keep you in darkness. He will keep you to sin until Jesus Christ come, and then you're going to be doomed. Friends, God, his creation power. Genesis, when God said, let there be light, and there was light. So when God said, be, means his creation power. You can be holy by the grace of God. This is the old gospel, and now the devil's using, hypnosis pastors. You know, all they want is, money, riding Mercedes and all kinds of expensive vehicles. They fail to be a Bible Christian. Christ is calling a humble instrument. If you are failed to be a Bible Christian, be converted. Time to take a stand. Forget yourself. Don't look for what's in it for you. It's time to look for what's in it for God. That's how apostles and disciples, they live in the first century. Jesus Christ is coming for the remnant church, means left over. Our character, our lifestyle is going to be like the first century, the church that Jesus Christ set up. Christ is coming. Believe that you're going to be holy. He's going to help you. It depends how you program yourself. If you are watching a Jesuit, Hollywood, worldly program, so-called television program, then the devil's going to use those pagans or infidels to preach you, and you're going to be in darkness until Jesus Christ comes. The phone number to order your own book is 856-503-5893. One more time, 856-503-5893. 93. Order The Great Controversy. Notice the book, The Great Controversy. And you can also get testimonies for the church, because it's preparation. It will prepare you by the grace of God. Friends, whenever they enforce their sun worship day, Sunday worship, whenever the law is in force in your country, do not accept it. The mark of the beast in their forehead, symbolic in Revelation, your forehead means your decision. And also when Revelation says their right hand means your action, will follow your decision once you accept their Sun Worship Day, when it's an enforced Sunday worship. Friends, take a stand. Christ is coming. He loved you so much so that when he was on the cross, Jesus Christ says, "I thirst." So whenever you're in temptation, remember when he says, "I thirst," because of you and I.